Let's consider the rational roots for a polynomial. We know for this polynomial, 3x squared minus 11x plus 10. The leading coefficient is 3 because the highest exponent is 2. So then this one is called 3 is called leading coefficient right here. 10 is the constant. We know this one has a rational root, which is 5 over 3. Why? You plug in 5 over 3 inside, okay, replace x with 5 over 3, x with 5 over 3. And then you know 5 over 3 squared is 5 squared over 3 squared, okay. And here is just 5 over 3, you copy it down here. Is this one going to be 0? Let's check. 5 squared is 25, times 3 is 75. So, numerator for the first term is 75 over 9. 9 is 3 squared. How about 11 times 5 over 3? 11 times 5 is 55. Downstairs is 3. You take this term down here. How to put those two together? You know, the first one is 75 over 9. The second one is 55 over 3. So denominators are not the same. 1 is 9, 1 is 3. Then you multiply 3 to both numerator and denominator. You'll have the denominator of the second term, which is 9. And then numerator is 3 times 55, which gives us 165. So denominator is 9. And then numerator is 75 minus 169. 75 minus 165 is negative 90 for numerator. Denominator is 9. Negative 90 divided by 9 is negative 10. So eventually you have this one is negative 10, and you have a plus 10, so you get 0. This tells us that this polynomial has a root 5 over 3 as a rational root. You see, 5 over 3 is a fractional number. All fractional numbers are rational numbers. All rational numbers can be converted to fractional numbers. So actually, fractional numbers are rational numbers. Okay, now here. We know this one is actually 0. I like to replace 5 over 3 by p over q right here, from here. Let's do a little bit math right here. Okay. If we here be careful, 5 with 3, 5 does not divide 3, and 3 does not divide 5. Okay, so it cannot be reduced more. So here is the case is that P does not divide Q, Q does not divide P. Okay, let's say P here is 5, Q here is 3. Okay, now then you know 5 replaced with P, Q to replace 3. Okay, so here is P is 5, Q is 3. And then we put 10 here, equals 0. Now, both sides multiplied by Q squared You know, right hand side is easy because it's 0 times q squared, that's 0. 10 times q squared is 10q squared. Okay? And then you know, q squared times q, you cancel one q downstairs. You have another q, which is upstairs. So here is pq. Okay, here is pq. Now q squared here times q squared downstairs, there is a q squared, so those two cancelled. Okay, so then you have our first one is 3p squared, the second term is 11p times q. Here one, this q is cancelled because there is a square over there. And then plus 10q squared. Right hand side is 0. Okay. Let's both sides minus 10q squared on both sides. Okay. So then you can cancel this one and you move negative 10q squared plus 0, you get this one. Okay, and then you copy the left hand side 3p squared negative 11pq down here on the left. Okay, those two cancelled, so nothing is on the left, and 0 plus negative 10q squared puts right here. We know right here there is a p here, and there is a p squared here. So you may take p out. Okay, if you take p out, then 3 times p without, here is no longer 2, because you pull p out. And then for the second 10 on the left hand side, you pull p out, you have 11p here. Here is subtraction. The right hand side, again, we copy down here, negative 10q squared. Now, if you look at this one, this is p times the whole quantity, equals negative 10 times q squared. Remember, what I said before is that p does not divide q, okay? It's like 3 does not divide, 5 does not divide 3, so p does not divide q. So p does not divide q. Since the multiplication of left-hand side equals the right-hand side, and p does not divide q, p does not divide q squared, then p has to divide 10, okay? So p divides 10, that's important. That's the very important conclusion. Why? Where is 10 from? 10 is from here, 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 here. That's the constant. So this tells us p divides this constant. So if this polynomial has a rational root, p over q, then p must divide this constant. Okay? So this basically tells us what are possible values of p. 1 divides 10, 2 divides 10, 3 does not, and then 5 divides 10, 10 divides 10. Okay? So the possible values for p would be 1, 2, 5, 10, positive, negative. Okay, so p divides constant. That's the important conclusion. P divides this constant. And this is true in general for polynomial with degree greater than 2. Okay, we don't want to get things more complicated. We just use a quadratic function. So then you might think, how about q? Q this 3, this q will divide the leading coefficient. That's the conclusion. Why? And here is the reason. Three steps, you'll find out the reason. Now, look at this one again. And then both sides minus 3p squared on both sides. Okay? And then you see these two will cancel each other. And minus 3p squared plus 0. So then will be negative 3p squared. Okay? So that's on the right-hand side. Left-hand side, those two cancel each other. You then have a left-hand side, those two tens. You put it right here. That's negative 11pq plus 10q squared. Okay? Now, again, here you see there is a common q. You can pull it out. If you pull it out, q, there is no more q for the first term, then that would be negative 11 times p plus 10q. Another q is out here. So this will make the whole quantity times q. Now, the whole quantity times q equals negative 3 times p squared. What's the meaning for that? Previously, we were told p does not divide q, q does not divide p. Here, q does not divide p squared. Because q does not divide p, so q does not divide p squared. Then q has to divide 3. Where is this 3 from? From here, from here, from here, from here, from here, from here. That's the leading coefficient. So this q divides 3, q divides 3. Then what are the possible values for q? The possible values for q would be what? Positive, negative 1, positive, negative 3. Okay? Again, what's the possible values for p? Positive, negative 1, positive, negative 2, positive, negative 5, or positive, negative 10. Okay? So, that's important. This tells us that if a polynomial has a rational root p over q, then numerator p divides constant, and then q divides, the denominator divides the leading coefficient. Okay? Then you know what are the possible rational root. One of them is 5 over 3, you see, 5 over 3, because q is the denominator, 5 over 3. Okay? Yeah, 10 over 3 might be the root. But if you put inside a check, it's not going to be the root. Okay, so here tells us all the possibilities, but not all of them are the roots, some of them. Here you can find out all the possibilities, but some of them are the real roots, some of them are not. Here 5 over 3 is the root. Okay, so this basically tells us if a polynomial has a rational root, then you can basically find out what are the possible values for pq and what are the possible rational numbers for the roots. Okay? I'll see you next time.